All right, so here's a quick video of a jukebox I've got in the shop. This is a this is an NSM Festival. Or Festivus? Festival? Festivus for the rest of us. No, it's an NSM Festival. And I must say, it's quite festive. It's got lots of lights. This is probably one of the most slick jukeboxes that I've ever had in here. NSM was a German jukebox manufacturer, and this was sort of more towards the end of vinyl playing jukeboxes. And what's kind of cool about this is that you can see the... Well, it's tough to... Yes, Nacho also really likes this NSM jukebox because it's cool. So I'm going to try and show you, I guess you can sort of see. So there's a weird effect going on here where I don't know if the camera's actually able to see it, but you can see the record player, the mechanism that makes all the magic happen is on full display in this, which is very cool. Yes, I know. So if you're somebody that's got a vinyl collection that they would like to put on display, this definitely is a good option. This late in the game, I think these came out in the late 70s, I think 78 until the early 80s, I suppose. This was really at the end for vinyl. CDs were right around the corner, so the technology was, you know, as good as it was going to get. And these NSMs, well, they're from Germany, so the engineering is really good on them. They're always very tacky and have lots of lights and cheesiness. So this one's no exception. I will say I added, so these LED lights inside, I added them, and I also added a, there's a mirror to reflect the light on the back to give it sort of a three-dimensional effect, so when you're looking into it, you see the light. Anyway, there's not really much point in describing it here because you probably can't see it. These lights also will change with the music, so once a song starts playing, well, then the party really gets going. A pretty clean machine, I gotta say. All in all, this is not the original, color. I guess this was added at some point. It had this on when I got it. It's supposed to have sort of a blue and a red stripe or something. So actually whoever did this did a pretty good job. There's a tiny scuff in the front here, but really nothing too bad. Overall, it's in very good shape, looks good, sounds good. Like I said, German engineering, so, you know, these are ultra reliable, ultra slick, and really unique. And yeah, by the time that this came out, the fact that it was a full visible mech is pretty cool. There were no, all the American companies by this time had, hidden everything away. So very, very cool. Anyway, before this gets too long, let's put on a song here. How about 1-1-1? And we'll see this mech here. I don't know if I can capture it. There we go. Pretty cool. Oh, I think we should turn that up.